Good morning, church. It's Thursday morning, and take your Bibles and turn to the book of Revelation, chapter number 19. Last time we looked at the feast and the beginning of the feast. Remember, that happens at the very end of the seven-year tribulation period. While all the terrible events of the earth are going on, the destruction of mankind, the reign of the Antichrist, all the political shenanigans and so forth that are involved in that time period, all that's going on earth, we have a time of pleasure in heaven. But at the very end of all that will come what is called the marriage feast of the Lamb. We've already talked about how that, I think, represents the marriage of a Jewish wedding customs. But I do want to look again at verse number 7 through 9. It says, "Let us rejoice and give glory to him, for the marriage of the Lamb has come, and his wife has made herself ready." And so it's very clear in Scripture that the Lamb of God, that is Jesus, is going to take a bride. And that bride, of course, we know as the church. And to her it was granted to be arrayed in fine linen, clean and bright, for the fine linen is the righteous acts of the saints. Now keep that in mind, because that will come into play in future devotions, that she's robed in fine linen, clean and white, beautiful is what she is. And that represents the righteous acts of the saints. And then verse number 9, "And then he said to me, Write, blessed are those who are called to the marriage supper of the Lamb. And he said to me, These are true sayings of God." So blessed are those who are called to this event. I won't go back and look at all the different parables where Jesus talked about a great wedding feast that was going to be given. People were invited, and many people who were invited didn't show up and are not going to be a part of this. And they sent people out into the hedges and highways to draw people in. But I noticed something about this. We don't get hardly any information about this wedding feast. I don't know what we're going to eat or drink. I don't know where the venue is going to be, what the size of the crowd is going to be, or the decorations. How's this going to be decorated out? Is this just going to be a plain feast out in the open field? Where's this going to be at? We don't know that, because that's not really important. The only important thing is this: people are going to be there. And most importantly, the bridegroom is going to be there. And his bride is going to be there. And the bridegroom is going to present to the other guest his bride and say, "This is my bride, and from now on, she will be my bride." No divorce. We're going to always be a part of Christ, because we are one with him, and therefore we are his bride. Now, who's the bride of Christ? Well, it is those believers who were saved from the descension of the Holy Spirit, that is, on the day of Pentecost, to the rapture of the church when God removes the Holy Spirit. That is the bride of Christ. Only those in that time period who come to the Lamb, who come to Christ and are saved, those are the only ones who are part of the bride of Christ. Well, who else is going to be at this event? Well, there's going to be the friends of the Father and the friends of the Son. That is, those people who have been invited and who have received the invitation. That includes, number one, the pre-flood saints, people like Abraham, and pre-flood is would be Adam and Eve, and Abel and Seth, and Enoch and Noah. Those people pre-flood who were believers, they're going to be there because they're friends of the Father. And then there's going to be the patriarchs there. Abraham and Isaac and Jacob are all going to be there. There will be people such as Rebecca, and I believe also Leah, possibly Rachel. Rachel seemed to be a worshiper of idols. I don't know if she ever got over that. But if she's part of the redeemed, then she will be there. And certainly Sarah will be there. And then there's the prophets, people like Moses and Joshua and Elijah and Elisha and Isaiah and Jeremiah and Daniel and Ezekiel and so forth. All those people who serve the Lord faithfully in their dispensation of time. So that's who's going to be there, the saints of old, as well as, I believe, those who died as martyrs after the rapture of the church. Those who were not a part of the bride, because the bride was removed at the rapture. But they are those who died after the rapture. They became saved by the testimonies, and they sealed their testimonies with death. They died, and they are a part of that as well. Now, what about the saved that are on the earth at this time? When the marriage feast of the Lamb is going on, what about those who are on the earth? They don't get to be a part of this? Well, no. This is for those who prior to this have been redeemed and have made it into heaven. Those on the earth that are alive and still in their bodies, when Christ returns with his bride, are going to go into the kingdom. Yes, they're a part of Christ and all that the kingdom is. They're going to be a part of that, but they're not a part of the bride. One question I have and I don't know the answer to is, what about the 144,000? It seems like Christ removed them off the earth, and we see them, I think, a picture of them in heaven after the seven-year tribulation period is over with. Are they there? I don't know. Possibly. Perhaps these 144,000, because they don't go through death, are also going to be reserved to come back to the earth, and they're going to be a part of those who repopulate the earth. They don't have their glorified bodies yet, I don't believe. And so maybe they're going to do that. I really don't know. I just know this. It's going to be a beautiful celebration. The greatest celebration, that when Christ said to his church, hey, this is the blood of the new covenant, drink you. He was given a marriage proposal to his church. And from that time on, he's not drank with anyone that cup, but he's going to drink it that night or that time at the marriage feast of the Lamb. I'm going to be a part of that. I hope you will be too. Make sure you have a relationship with Jesus Christ, because the only ones going to be in heaven are those who are his bride and the friends of the Father. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for calling us unto salvation that we might know Jesus as Lord and Savior. We pray, Father, and look forward to that time when we're going to be with you, united completely with Christ as his bride. Until that time, help us to be faithful. Help us to be chaste, always looking forward to the coming of our Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.